Hello students, today we will discuss about the AC circuit analysis for resistor. That means if a single phase AC supply is given to the resistor, how the circuit behaves, how the circuit analyzation is done, what are the parameters we have to learn is analyzed by this AC circuit analysis for resistor. Simply, AC supply is given in terms of voltage source. So, in AC voltage source V equal Vm sin omega t is applied to the resistor. So, whenever a source, voltage source or current source is applied to the resistor, actually it is a closed loop. This is a closed loop. So, whenever voltage source is there, resistor is there, power is transferred by the current. That means power will be transferred like this. Okay, so first the voltage supply is applied to the resistor equal to V equal to Vm sin omega t simply, but we don't know current. We have to find out the current. So simply you have to apply KVL by KVL to the circuit as simply minus V I into R equal to 0. By that we will find out I equal to V by R. But what about AC supply voltage? AC supply voltage formula is Vm sin omega t by R. So finally current equal, in place of Vm by R directly I can write Vm by R means simply voltage by resistance. Voltage by resistance according to the Ohm's law I equal to V by R simply replacing Vm by R with Im. So this is become Im sin omega t. So the current flowing through the resistor whenever single phase AC supply is given to the resistor, the current value is Im sin omega t. Nothing but current is also sinusoidal waveform. We are applying the voltage is single phase AC sinusoidal, by getting the current is also sinusoidal waveform. That's why look at here. So you know that the single phase AC voltage waveform is like this. This blue line is the V. The maximum value is Vm. Current waveform, there is no change of current. There is no change in current in phase. So for the resistor, the voltage where the waveform starts, at that point only current waveform will also start. So that's why the current is represented in red ink. This is also started zero and its current waveform is like this. Why the magnitude is less? Because Vm by R, we are dividing voltage with resistors. So the magnitude will be decreased. So that's why we will get Im here. The Im sin omega t we will get here. Understand? Right. The phasor diagram for this resistor, voltage and current, the phasor diagram for this single phase resistor, voltage, I am considering the voltage as reference because it will start at zero. Simply, this is the voltage. Applied voltage starts from zero. That's why I take it the straight line. This is the magnitude. What about Im? Im is also starts from zero only, but the magnitude is less. That's why I am taking like this. This is the phasor diagram of the single phase AC supply is given to the resistor. This is the phasor diagram. Then we will write the power equation also. Power equation directly we can write like power across the resistor is V RMS into IRMS directly, because there is no power factor actually, generally power factor, but power factor for the resistor is always 1. So power equal to VRMS equal, we know that Vm by root 2, and IRMS value is Im by root 2 cos pi is 1. This is the power flowing through the resistor. This is the power flowing through the resistor. So by this single phase AC circuit analysis, simply voltage or current in same phase. That's why voltage waveform started 0, current waveform also started 0. So same as phasor diagram also, voltage waveform started 0 with magnitude. So this is the big line. And what about current? Current is a smaller line but started 0. Okay, this is about single phase AC circuit analysis for the resistor, series resistor. Power is simply this is the power. Okay, now the next topic is AC circuit analysis for L. L means inductor. That means a single phase AC supply is applied to the inductor. So what are the changes we have to analyze? So the analyzation is about the, for a element, here the element is the inductor, AC supply is applied, what are the changes? So here, before that, we have to study inductor some properties. Inductor have some changes, inductor and capacitor have some changes compared with the resistor. Look at here, generally in case of resistor, directly resistor have the resistance in terms of ohms directly, but in case of inductor is a simply element, it has units of L, but these inductive elements Henry is not enough to analyze the circuits. That's why, so inductor has as a property which opposes sudden changes in the current, but inductor itself has some, it has a property, some resistive properties itself. That resistive property is the inductive reactance, that is inductive reactance. Inductor also opposes the current. So it has some property, that property called as inductive reactance. Why it is called reactance? This has the resistive property, but in terms of imaginary element. But in terms of, it has an imaginary element. Understand? So that inductive itself has some resistance. This resistance is represented with the inductive reactance. That inductive reactance represents with the symbol XL. XL, that means inductive reactance. So that XL is the value of J omega L. J omega L. J represents imaginary term. Omega L is the value of the inductors. So if you, it is rectangular form because it's imaginary term. If you are converted into polar form, polar is magnitude with the phase angle, with the angle plus 90 degrees, imaginary term. So otherwise we can write it also like this, that is XL magnitude of 90 degrees. Understand? Yes, this is about inductive reactance. But what about omega? Omega is angular velocity. Angular velocity formula is 2 phi f, 2 into 5 into f. F is the frequency of the supply. So generally L is, you have to remind, L the units are Henry's, XL units are ohms. XL units are ohms. That's why we have to convert this Henry's into the ohms. That's why XL is introduced, right? So every inductor is there, in the inductor have some inductive reactance. Inductive reactance is the only term we have to use in the equations, we have to analyze in the circuits. Okay, so here in this AC circuits, we are taking the AC supply. This AC supply V is applied to the inductor. So whenever a supply is connected to some element, current will be flowing. This represents with current I. The current I will be flowing in the closed circuit. So we have to find out this current. So generally this voltage supply, directly we can write current into inductive reactance. Otherwise, you have to apply simply KVL. If you apply the KVL, minus V plus I into wherever the inductor is, you have to write inductive reactance, not L. Not L. Why? Because ohms into resistance will give only voltage. That's why you have to write the inductive reactance. In place, in the equations, you have to write the XL. From that, you can write V equal I into XL. Then what is you have to requirement? Your requirement is to find out the current I. Current I equal V by XL. You know single phase AC supply V equal Vm sin omega t. What about XL? XL equal, you have to write omega L by 90. Omega L is magnitude, 90 is angle. Where it comes? It comes from j omega L, right? So I equal, this is the real parts, V, this is the magnitudes Vm by omega L, one thing. Another thing is sin, wherever the angle is there, that angle is, so it is the dividable thing, the angle will be subtracted. So that's why sin omega t minus 90, sin omega t minus 90. That's why current equal, this Vm by omega L, directly I can write the Im of the inductor. Sin of omega t minus 5 by 2, 90 is nothing but the 5 by 2, understand? So finally, we will get, we are applying a single phase supply to an inductor, the inductor current will be like this, inductor current is Im sin omega t minus 5 by 2, sin omega t minus 5 by 2. So by using these equations, we can draw the waveforms. So first, look at the blue line, blue ink. Blue is the, this is the voltage waveform. But what about red ink? Red ink, it starts from the 5 by 2. It starts from the 5 by 2. Why 5 by 2? If you observe the equation, it is not sin omega t. It is sin omega t minus 5 by 2. After 5 by 2, the waveform will be starts. So that's why you have to start the waveform at 5 by 2. So this is the waveform. And this is for, you have to pure inductor. Keep in your mind, pure inductor, there is no resistance and there is no mixer with the resistance actually, okay? There is no mixer with the resistance, pure inductance, it have inductive reactance, right? So that's why like this. So this waveform, you can write in the phasor diagrams. So voltage V starts at 0, that's why you start at 0 point. But what about current? Current is after 90 degrees it will start. That means we can call it as lags, current lags, that is I. It is called as in inductor current lags voltage by 90 degrees. Voltage by 90 degrees. This is called as current lags voltage by 90 degrees. Understand? This is called as lagging. Why it is lagging? Minus 90 is there. In the equation, minus 90 is. That's why it's lagging. Wherever minus is there, you have to write. Wherever plus is there, you have to write up. So finally, in inductor, whenever AC supply is given, if it is a pure inductor, the inductor current is lags voltage by 90 degrees. Lags voltage by 90 degrees. And you have to remind the inductive reactance. Inductive reactance. Wherever the equation is, please don't write inductor, just write inductive reactance. Inductive reactance formula is like that. Okay. This is about the, so, and we can write the power equation. Power is voltage into current into power factor. Vrms, Irms into cos pi. Okay. So this is about the AC circuit analysis for the inductor. Okay. Now we will discuss about the AC circuit analysis for capacitor. It's for pure capacitor. So last class, we will discuss about the resistor and inductor. Now we will discuss about the capacitor. You know that capacitor. Capacitor is having two plates, look like this. Yes, whenever single phase AC supply is supplied to the capacitor, when the current flow is flowing like this, right? Before that, we have to understand capacitive reactance. So inductor and capacitor both are the reactive elements. these are imaginary elements. That's why it has the reactance for both. Both for inductor and capacitor are the reactive elements. Reactive elements. That's why capacitor also having the capacitive reactance. So, wherever the capacitor is, capacitor having the capacitive reactance. That capacitive reactance having the units are ohms. The capacitive reactance formula is 1 by J omega C. 1 by J omega C. So, it is in rectangular form. If we convert into the polar form, 1 by omega C is the magnitude, angle is minus 90. Why it is minus 90? Wherever the J is 1 by J. 1 by J is simply, we can write like this also, minus J by omega C. Wherever the minus J is there, you will get minus 90. Finally, 1 by omega C can be write it as XC for our convenience, capacitive reactance. Its phase is minus 90. Its phase is minus 90. So, simply, we can write another thing. Capacitor units are farad. You know that the Faraday. But capacitor reactance units are ohms. Simply, we are converting the Faradays into the ohms. In the previous session, there Henrys are converted into the ohms. You have to mind it. But the angle is minus 90, magnitude is like this. So now we are applying single phase AC supply to the capacitors. Whenever a single phase supply is supplied to the capacitance, the current will be flowing in this circuit. So simply, in order to analyze this current, just simply applying the KVL. That KVL represents minus V plus I into XC equal to 0. From that V equal to I into XC. From that I equal V by XC. Just remind it. In place of, all of you confused that, you have to directly write C. Don't write C, you have to write the capacitive reactance. That's why ohms into amperes into ohms will give voltage only. Amperes into Faraday doesn't give the voltage. Understand? Right. Here V equal to I into XC. I equal to V by XC. V is a single phase AC supply. V equal to Vm sin omega t. And XC equal to 1 by omega C at an angle of minus 90. So from that, current I equal to Vm by 1 by omega C. XC sin omega t plus 90. Right? Otherwise, you can write like this also, minus J XC. This will be simple. Okay. So, direct V by 1 by omega C, you can directly write it as Im. Here, minus 90, in the denominator, it has minus 90. Whenever it enter into the numerator, it will become plus 90. So, I equal Im sin omega T plus 90. Power is simply directly P equal to VRMS. Power is voltage into current. But here, RMS voltage into RMS current. So, power equal to VRMS, this IRMS into cos pi. Okay, right. Now, we will write the phasor diagrams. Simply, voltage is Vm sin omega t. Simply, voltage, you know that Vm sin omega t. Vm is the magnitude and sin omega t is the phase. So, directly, so starts from 0 only. Look at the red ink, 0 only, and it will follow the like this. With a time period of 2 phi. But what about current? Look at the current here. Current equal Im sin omega t plus phi by 2. That means plus 90. This current will be 90 degrees will be added for that current. So for that 90 degrees, that's why before 0, I keep again a 90. So 90 is nothing but same phase, 90, 90. So I'm starts here 90. So that's why the curve will flow like this. Understand? In case of inductor, the current waveform will be start here. It follows this path. But in case of capacitor, the curve starts from 5 by 2. Understand? Where it gets only simply from equation. But in case of voltage is simply from equation. Right? Simply from equation. So now we will draw the phasor diagram for this pure capacitor. For this pure capacitor, here voltage is Vm sin omega t. Simply just write. So this is the voltage. This is the phase zero. Now current, you have to draw the current. Current, look at the current waveform. Current waveform is Im sin omega t plus 90. You have to add the plus 90. Plus 90 means leading. Leading means you have to plus 90 degrees. Wherever the plus 90 is, you have to draw for up. This is the current waveform. This is the current waveform. So plus 90 is there. Plus 90 is there. You have to draw the upside. You have to draw the upside. This is called as in capacitor, current leads voltage by plus 5/2. Voltage by 5/2. Understand? Current leading means current starts before the voltage. Look at here. Current starts here, but voltage starts here. That's why current leads voltage. In the phasor diagram, you have to draw the up. Plus 90 means the 90 will be increases like this. Minus 90 means downwards, right? So current leads voltage by 90 degrees. For in case of inductor, downwards, because current lags. Current lags means backside. So this is about the AC circuit of the capacitor. You have get some confusion here. Don't confuse here. Simply capacitive reactance is 1 by j omega c. So omega c is the 1 by omega c is the magnitude, and this is the phase minus 90, and this is the farad. Converted into, it will become ohms. Understand? This is about the single phase AC circuit for capacitor. Just keep in your mind, the thing is inductive, capacitive are the reactive elements. So that's why inductor, capacitor have the reactances. Inductor have reactance of inductive reactance. Capacitive have reactance of the capacitive reactance. Both reactances units are ohms. Why it is called as reactance? Reactance means it's imaginary things. Imaginary things means that's why you will get plus J. J here, right? There is a small difference is there. If you observe clearly, you will understand clearly. Okay? Thank you.